this late night. We hope you're doing well. And now, if you don't mind, we're going to get to the news. The New Hampshire primary was today. We tape early, so we don't know what happened, but yeah, we do. It's like going to a Mets game. Sure, it hasn't started yet, but we know who lost. That's right. Today was the New Hampshire primary, and then tomorrow, diner customers can go back to eating their meals in peace. According to new reports, former First Lady Melania Trump plans to campaign for former President Trump, but not at routine events, just the ones she's subpoenaed for. In a new interview, presidential candidate Nikki Haley questioned former President Trump's mental fitness and said that she thinks he is, quote, declining, while Trump thinks Nikki Haley is that lady from Law & Order. Former President Trump had held a rally last night in New Hampshire with three of his former Republican primary opponents, Vivek Ramaswamy, Tim Scott, and a teleprompter. The Supreme Court ruled yesterday that Border Patrol agents can remove razor wire from the U.S.-Mexico border. Apparently, Trump's been cutting up his hands trying to escape. What's a bigger bummer, that we got a former president with a handful of sores or that he's the front runner? A Japanese author who recently won a literary award revealed last week that she used artificial intelligence to help write the novel, which is totally unfair to authors who write without the help of any intelligence. Authorities in New York's JFK Airport recently arrested a man after they allegedly found 40 pounds of cocaine hidden inside multiple packages of frozen jumbo shrimp. They first became suspicious when he tried to board an airplane with multiple packages of frozen jumbo shrimp. Do you want me to help you put those in the overhead? No. Builders in Italy recently unearthed the ruins of a 2,000-year-old beach house, and like all beach houses, it included the dumbest sign you've ever seen. Authorities in California recently arrested a man at a Planet Fitness gym after he allegedly threatened other patrons with a knife while naked. Wow. Planet Fitness, what happened to your judgment-free zone? According to a new analysis, Florida is the best state to retire. Convenient. A yogurt company is offering $10,000 to participants who can stay off their phone for 1 month by locking it in a box. Do you have to eat the yogurt, too? Because if I eat yogurt, I'm going to need my phone. I don't have hard copies of Wordle. And finally, you have to fill it out, and then you mail it in. A couple days later, it comes back. You find. And finally, a Virgin Atlantic flight in England was canceled recently after passengers told a flight attendant that several screws were missing from the plane's wing. Even worse, they had like four of these things just left over. And that was a monologue, everybody. We are off and running. We've got a great show for you tonight. She is an Emmy winner, you know, from American Crime Story and American Horror Story and so much more. She's now on Broadway. Starring in Appropriate, our friend Sarah Paulson will be here. She's a very funny comedian and a cast member from Saturday Night Live. Punky Johnson is on the show tonight, everybody. And he's a best-selling novelist, comic book writer, and his children's book series, Ordinary People Change the World, is hands down the best gift to send to new parents. His latest, I Am Ruth Bader Ginsburg, is out now. Brad Meltzer is on the show, so I'm coming back. You guys, I do a podcast with my brother. It's called Family Trips with the Meyers Brothers. That's the two of us when we were children. And this week, we talked to the very funny Mike Birbiglia. Do a check it out. Give it a listen wherever you get your podcasts. Also, you got a very harrowing thing happened to me this weekend. My wife was out of town. I had all three kids, you know? Pretty impressive. We still have all three, which I think is really... Anyway, you know, I'm a little stressed out. It's bath time. I'm trying to get the kids ready to go. And all of a sudden, the dog starts barking, and she's in another room, and the lights are off, and it's dark. And so I go into the other room, and we have our summer umbrella that we have outside, that we put outside in the summer, and it's leaned up behind the bathroom door. Now, again, it's dark, so I don't know that the umbrella is there. I should, because it's always there. But I go in to help the dog, and all of a sudden, I hear a rustling and that I hear somebody behind the door, what I think is somebody, and I think to myself, well, this is it. You know, this is how it ends. There's somebody who's been hiding in this room, and now I'm about to go down. But in a moment of what I would say great bravery, I decided I'm not going to cower in fear. I'm going to run towards the intruder. And that was the mistake I made, because that's when the umbrella hit me in the head. And, like, it cut this part open. And that wasn't the bad part. The bad part was the next day, I just wore a giant Band-Aid over my head. And I took my kids skiing, and I was in the lodge, and everybody kept coming up to me being like, hey, what happened? And the thing about wearing a Band-Aid is you get used to it and you forget you have it. And so people are like, what happened? I'm like, what are you talking about? And they're like, there's a giant Band-Aid on your head. And you guys, here's the thing. I just turned 50, and I'm like, I think I maybe just turned 80. I'm just like an old dude with a Band-Aid on my head, have no idea what it's from. Also, you know, we make a lot of fun of the fact, we show a clip all the time of Donald Trump bringing an umbrella up the airplane steps, and he can't figure out how to fold it up, and he just leaves it there. And, you know, you might say this is karma for me making fun about him not knowing what to do with it. But I want to say something, and I think this is true. That man runs from an umbrella, and I ran to it. I ran to it. Also, you might be like, is this it here? No, that's from yesterday. I ran into a door. For 2 out of the last 3 days, I've been holding ice to my head and to my kids. And let me just say, that takes away the high ground when you say to your kids, like, what's wrong with you? And they're like, what's wrong with you, Dad? You guys, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis suspended his presidential campaign over the weekend, but there are still some important questions that have gone unanswered, so we decided to drag him back on stage for one last debate. That's right, Governors Ron DeSantis and Nikki Haley are here right now, and they're ready to go. So without further ado, here's a late night's final 2024 Republican presidential debate. Welcome to the late night Republican presidential debate. I'm your moderator, Seth Meyers. Let's jump right in. Governor DeSantis, now that you have suspended your campaign, is your wife looking forward to having you back at home in Florida?
You won't be able to find her if you had a search warrant.
Governor Haley, Donald Trump said the presidents should have total immunity regardless of how serious the crime. What kind of president would say something like that?
A president that's looking at 20 and 30 years.
Governor DeSantis, what are you going to do with all the campaign money you have left?
We tear it up and we throw it in the trash can.
Governor Haley, where do you think it should go?
I want that money.
Governor DeSantis, is it true that you were a little nervous backstage?
There's maybe a puddle there.
Governor Haley, what would you be doing right now if you weren't running for president?
Driving a combine or holding a pig at a produce area.
Governor DeSantis, are you a big football fan?
Yes.
The NFL Conference Championships are this weekend. Let's hear your picks. Who you got?
We're going to choose Midland over Moscow. We're going to choose the Marcellus Shale over the Mullahs. And we're going to choose the Bakken over Beijing.
Did you watch the Marcellus Shale game last week?
I was there for that.
So just curious, where is their home stadium?
Beautiful, liberal Martha's Vineyard.
I don't think you are a big football fan. Ambassador Haley, where should I go if I'm learning to become a rapper?
Drake University.
Good one. Governor DeSantis, when we wrote this sketch, you were coming off a second-place finish in Iowa, and it looked like you'd hang around for at least a few more weeks. Did you drop out right before New Hampshire just to f*** us?
You can't trust politicians.
Yeah. Governor Haley, as president, how would you combat the rising costs of ambulance rides?
We're going to take the patient out of the back seat and put them in the driver's seat.
Okay, Governor DeSantis, it's time to play pyramid. You ready? Okay. Here we go. Banning LGBTQ books.
Things that are going to help seniors.
No. Complaining about someone's preferred pronouns.
Things in Florida.
No. Gay characters in Disney movies.
Things that's hitting working people the most.
No. Companies being too woke.
Things that happened during COVID.
No. What bathroom someone uses.
Things that no voter cares about.
Yes! Good job! You got it! Oh, you'd be happier. Governor Haley, what do you and your husband like to do for fun?
Standing with our friends and doing some other things.
Governor DeSantis, you said you had a girlfriend all through high school, but none of your classmates ever saw her. Why is that?
She was in another state.
Okay. Governor Haley, you took some criticism for claiming that the Civil War wasn't about slavery. I'll give you the chance tonight to clarify what you meant. What was the main cause of the Civil War?
COVID.
No, that's not right. Try again.
Electric vehicles.
Nikki, come on.
Homeschoolers.
Still wrong. Last chance.
Joe Biden.
Oh, come on. That's impossible. He was only in, like, fourth grade in 1861. Am I right? You get it. Governor DeSantis, is it true that you wrote a sequel to Encanto where the family tries to come to America, but they all get deported?
Yeah, the media didn't like it, the left didn't like it, and Disney didn't like it.
Yeah, well, sounds bad. Governor DeSantis, what do you call it when you put ranch dressing on your alphabet cereal?
Word salad.
And what do you get if you eat too much of it?
Word vomit.
Governor Haley, what happens if someone is listening to Pink Floyd's albums in chronological order and they get too depressed?
They get to the wall and they have to turn around and go back.
Governor DeSantis, who makes the best alarm clocks?
Woke corporations.
Good one. Don't smile. Ambassador Haley, what's your favorite kind of fishing?
Catch and deport.
Governor DeSantis, what would you do if Joe Biden challenged you to a fight?
I am not going to mess with seniors.
Yeah. Plus, he looks like he's got that old man strength.
Seniors are really strapped.
Governor. It's a weird syntax, Governor. Seniors are really strapped. Governor Haley, what's the scariest part of driving a Tesla?
Exploding.
Governor DeSantis. Governor DeSantis, finish this famous lyric. You put your right hand in, you put your right hand out.
You raise that hand, you put that left hand on the Bible.
Governor Haley, what was the worst part about smoking a joint with Governor DeSantis?
Ron didn't pass it for 5 years.
Ron! Ron, did you not puff, puff, pass? Stop smiling! Governor Haley, what's one thing we have in common?
We don't have tattoos before the age of 18.
That's right, you know. I got a tattoo of a star with Dua Lipa a few weeks ago. What's your tattoo of?
42 million Americans on food stamps.
That's a lot of ink. Governor DeSantis, what's your tattoo of?
Homeless veterans.
You guys are weird! Governor DeSantis, make your best effort to explain what twerking is.
I think that that's a bottom-up thing.
Not bad. Governor DeSantis, any tips for newlywed couples on their wedding night?
You gotta be methodical, strategic about it. There's a lot of moving parts.
Oh, that's right. Governor DeSantis, this is the last time we're gonna see you. Do you have any last words for the American people?
Ballistic podiatry.
You are such a weird dude. Smiling! Looks like we're out of time, so on behalf of the candidates, have a good one. We'll be right back with Sarah Paulson, everybody!